So next, we have Nikos Tanzas from Ideology, who's going to talk about Peter's influences on his work. Thank you, Nikos.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Am I heard? Hello? 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 Okay. All right. Am I heard? Good. Thanks. Welcome to another beautiful day on the beach. That was Peter's first phrase in the seminar we started back in 2001. And suddenly everybody's reaching his back for sun oil. And that was the idea. And that was fantastic. And fantastic is here to be here with you, among all beautiful people and knowledgeable, to celebrate the life achievements of our beloved doctor, Peter Lang. Thank you very much, Gail, for inviting me. And for sure, appreciative is very rewarding. And this very event today is a proof of it. And let me introduce myself, so to connect with you. My name is Nikos Giannos, coming from Athens, Greece. I'm a systemic consultant and team mentor, and I've been practicing for 15 years appreciative inquiry in organizations, schools, corporations, big multinationals. So, and I'm also at the same time founder of a small consultancy boutique called Ideology that was started back in 2002 with the dream to initiate philosophy, art, and strategy for organizational development and cultural growth in organizations. Here we have artists, we have researchers, we have team coaches, we have yoga teachers, we have strategists all together. So it's a great team. And here is about the essence, I believe, of the whole teaching I had about the essence of appreciative inquiry. For me, it's the essence is a dream, the dream. So let me sing again, sing a little bit, because I took this from the lyrics you have heard, maybe, as soon as I sing to you. We're dreaming again, hallelujah, dreaming again, oh, we're dreaming again, hallelujah. I think that's the spirit. That's exactly the spirit of what Peter has taught us. And I would like, before I start my presentation, to see how I connect with my work, the dreams. Thank you very much for the clapping, it was very encouraging. Here is the training we had in a very hospitable place in Athens, four times with Smaro. Here we are in Sunia with our beloved friends here, all together, and here is Smaro. All together here we work in the seminar. So four big seminars with Peter. And what I've learned in these seminars. What I've learned in these seminars is that when valuable and beautiful things of life diminish their presence inside and outside of us, then the appreciative language raises people so they can be at their best and dream again these beautiful and wonderful things they believe are in their lives. And another thing I learned is that we carry with our posture and our being when we enter into organization, our culture, and our culture is our language. So we connect our culture in the system as soon as we get in there. And that is very important to keep in mind, and I always keep in mind that. So what are the gifts that Peter, according to me, have offered to systemic community and beyond? For me, I think that a very important thing is ability spotting. I recently learned, I was informed by Elizabeth, that ability spotting was created between Peter and Elizabeth in a talk back in 1973. I was trying on the internet to search where is ability spotting, who has invented that, and I realized that nobody has mentioned that. And that's great, we are here and we are witnessing this fantastic tool, ability spotting. And the other thing I will not refer to today is defining contexts, to place in the spotting abilities while we're exploring the future possibilities. We saw a little while ago the contextual change. That's very important, how we understand the contexts, how we get in there. So, what I've witnessed in Peter, that's I think the essence. I've witnessed Peter a lot of times, and the idea is that Peter's craft language so beautifully, within a dialogue that words can smoothly breathe in you the needed courage to voice and to pursue your dreams. And that's the essence of it, I believe. That's the essence of Peter's work and Peter's ideas. And so how I have elaborated on that. I took these ideas and how I have elaborated the last 15 years. So let's be in the same context. How I perceive the idea of the theory of appreciative inquiry, how it's applied in Europe. So the first thing is, as a consultant or therapist, take a relations responsibility stance and an aesthetical stance. Then we start digging and eliciting abilities. Some way, while we're exploring, we draw a morality line so we can have some border. And then within that, we start building the identity of the person or the system we have to work with in order to gracefully grow. And that's the idea of how I perceive the training. And what is of all of this, if the most important part, according to me, is the ability spotting. And when the abilities are put into language, automatically become values. And what we mean by values? Value is a word for a beautiful action that we value as important for our life. And when we repeat, and we like to repeat it, and when we repeat it, we call it virtue. And that's exactly what Peter has taught us, that when values put into action, become virtues. That's exactly the idea. So then, okay, what is virtue? So what is virtue? So then we go to another very important philosopher as well, Aristotle. Has wrote two great books about ethics. So he has deepened into the meaning of the virtue. And what is virtue? Virtue is the search for an excellence in an action. But he goes a little bit farther. He says also that we search an excellence, but excellence is the balance between two extremes, deficiency and excess. So now we have a little bit a map to know what we're looking for, especially when we get into organizations. So I came up with the idea saying that by spotting abilities in people's stories, what we are really looking at is to spot either existing virtues or desired values. That is virtues that we don't have again, we don't have yet. And then I asked myself, why we need, why values and abilities and virtues are so important? And I answer, because with values and abilities, we search our dreams, we follow for our dreams. So it's the ladder. Ladder is the values and the desires, the desired values we need to reach for the dreams. And when we're talking about organization, we're talking about vision. So let's see, in our small boutique, we keep developing appreciative inquiry because it's very important too for us. So while we're training our team coaches when we are to intervene in a big system, we have to know what is value. So we came up with a definition of the value so we all understand what we're looking for when we're getting into an organization. So value is a wish or a commitment to grow an existing or a new attitude, behavior or skill to excellence with an aim to become virtue, so we can confidently reach our dreams. So we know 2 minutes only. Well, that's great. So you can go a little bit, okay. Okay, I'll skip that. Okay, we have this for the vision. I'll go a little bit. Vision is the voice of a common desire, because we're getting people together, like it was this before, we're about to dream something. So what is about to dream? Vision is a shared dream. What is a shared dream? It's a vision. Vision is the voice of a common desire that people have for what they would like to become. This is the first thing. And so to offer a valuable and beautiful things to their fellow citizens, an action that will make proud and content. That's the idea we are looking for, and we help people to co-construct. And this comes also from Aristotle saying that the greatest virtues are those which are most useful to other people. Virtues is not good for us, Virtue is something that we give to others so that they become virtuous. And, okay, that's number one priority for organizations. The last 30 years, this is a research took place in the United States. Maybe you are acquainted with the book, In Research of Excellence, where the most successful United States companies, that the ones that lasted the more time, their leaders, the main contribution of their leaders was to clarify the value system of the organization and breathe life into it. So that's exactly the same thing we're doing ourselves. So how I've used Peter's theory in practice. Well, we are somehow a coach, this is Peter's proverb. We create a vacuum, a containing part with love and caring and curiosity. So we enter, and what we've done in ideology, we have prepared in the last 15 years three complementary tools to support leadership teams to embark, engage in, and implement cultural growth programs. And these three programs, three tools, one called Vision Value Day, okay, and other appreciative dialogue and identity acts. So I finish here. Thank you very much for listening. And thank you. I have a few more things to present, no problem. So thank you very much, Peter, for everything. Thank you for everything. And I would like now to present you with a gift that coming from our artist, which is your portrait. And since we're talking about aesthetics, I would like to offer you that on behalf of our people. And this is the one. Yeah, let's see. And also, I would like to present for all, I believe we have taught 700 people and 15 coaches the ability spotting in Greece. And this on their behalf, because they were exposed to your ideas, is the Nassian coming from Virginia. It's a small token for our appreciation for your work and how you have influenced us. So, and before I end, I have some more gifts. One is for Smara. Thank you very much for, getting in contact with them. And for you, Elizabeth, and us, well, thank you very much indeed for everything. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. That is fantastic.
Very interesting to hear an example of how people have been developing Peter's ideas.